We've got Bellator Rising Cross promotional event. It will take place. I think it will take place in Japan, let me check. But yeah. Saitama Super Arena, Japan. And now let's see. Oh, there are great bouts in the main card, and you know, I'll cover the whole main card here in predictions. The first bout is a catchweight match between Michael Page and Shin Shanzai. You know, for Michael Page, that he is a very, very venomous guy. A kickboxer, a black sash, or a brown sash in Laogar, I'm pretty much unsure. He was KO'd by Douglas Lima, but bounced back with two wins over Richard Kiel and Giovanni Melido, and he is definitely a guy who likes to clown the owner of the Knockout of the Year 2016. On the other side, Shin Shanzai is a strong Japanese fighter. He is a lot, way a lot smaller, but he is the former Pancrase middleweight champion. He suffered a loss to Jake Matthews at UFC, but bounced back with a technical decision over Yuichiro Sato at Deep 91. He is a former UFC fighter, so this could be a very, very serious test for our lovely Michael Page. Honestly hope that Michael Page is going to win, but Shin Shanzai is a dangerous guy and I'm not underestimating him. And now one of my favorite fighters, Darren Cruikshank. Darren, second degree black belt in Taekwondo. I interviewed his lovely student Cody Stamen, and Cody, thank you so much, man, for accepting the chance to interview the Detroit superstar. Well, he is a Taekwondoka, former UFC fighter who didn't have the great UFC career because he was pretty much unlucky with the fights. But yeah, his head kicks were amazing, his performances were amazing. And you know that he even fought Jorge Masvidal and Antonin Okwani on the other side. Let's see his last results. He has two losses in a row, but before that he defeated three fighters, Koshi Matsumoto, Tom Santos and Diego Brandao. He fights in many promotions. We got Damian Brown and Tofik Musaev, who defeated him. Damian Brown via guillotine choke, Tofik Musaev via unanimous decision, and now he squares off against Goiti Yamauchi. Well, this is a dangerous Brazilian. Dangerous BJJ black belt under Fernandinho Vieira. A dangerous coach. So this is the collision of styles. But Darren Cruikshank is good in wrestling. And I only hope that Darren Cruikshank is not gonna let him take him down, because in stand-up Yamauchi is weaker. I hardly vouch for Cruikshank because I love Cody, because I love Darren, but his opponent is tough. Goiti Yamauchi won Daniel Weichel and Saad Awad in last two bouts. Last was defeated to Michael Chandler, so this is gonna be a war. And now we've got in women's flyweight division Keina Watanabe versus Ilara Yuan. Keina Watanabe, she is a dangerous Japanese judoka. I follow her on Twitter, on Instagram, and I simply love the way she fights, the way she trains. She's so dedicated girl. She trains every day, every single day. Okay, she was fighting Japanese guys mostly and girls. She has only one draw. But now Ilara Yuan could be the greatest test of her career, because Ilara, she is a Bellator fighter who knee-barred back rollings, and she has awesome BJJ skills. So I think Keina Watanabe could ground and pound her. This is what I believe might happen. But on the other side, don't take me wrong, if Ilara grabs her limb, the bout is going to be over very, very soon. So yeah, now let's go. Keita Nakamura versus Lawrence Larkin. Keita Nakamura, man, is there anything I should speak about this wonderful legend? 47 fights, 34, 10, 2, 1. A great score. And he is a former UFC fighter. I mean, I remember this Keita Nakamura, but in last three fights he lost to Anthony Rocco Martin, to Sultan Aliyev, and defeated Salim Tuahri. He didn't fight some really big names, you know, only Li Jingliang, but he defeated Li Jingliang, and this speaks a lot about his performances. He's a tough guy, tough dude. This is how I like to call him. The other side, Lawrence Larkin, the Monsoon. Well, the name speaks more than 1,000 words, you know. The Monsoon is also a very, very tough name, who is on a great streak of 3 wins over Fernando Gonzalez, Ion Pascu and Andrei Koreshkov. He is the man who squared off for the Bellator welterweight championship, where he was barely outlasted by Douglas Lima, and yeah, I am pretty much sure this is gonna be a war. This is unpleasant decision, but I'm saying Lawrence Larkin, but very, very unpleasant decision. Now catchweight bout between Michael Chandler and Sydney Outlaw. Hell yeah, man. About this fight, I can only say that this is probably one of the greatest clashes ever. I mean, Michael Chandler, you all know him, there is no need to talk much about him. Michael Chandler is a former wrestler, and he is a really, really awesome guy who defended and won vacant Bellator lightweight world championship, and he was the former Bellator champion on many occasions. He even won it against Brent Primus, but lost it against Patricio Fryer via those TKO punches, and he is a really, really awesome guy. He is looking for a way to bounce back. On the other side, we got Sydney Outlaw, who is also a tough, tough dude. I only know about this guy that he has a 14-3, I think, score, and he is undefeated, believe it or not, since 2016, with last loss to Gregor Gillespie, a UFC fighter. I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 wins in a row. Alright, he also defeated Roger Huerta, so yeah. Listen, you will probably criticize me for this, but I think Outlaw is going to defeat him here. And now the Clash of Legends, the heavyweight battle between Fedor Emelianenko and Quinton Rampage Jackson. Michael Page, I said everything I said. Fedor Emelianenko, the real legend of this sport, and you know what happened in his bout against Ryan Bader. Fedor is a former Pride champion, the former real, real legend of Pride, who has never participated in a UFC battle. On the other side, Quinton Jackson is also a Pride legend, and you know that Quinton is one of the bravest guys, the slam expert, but he didn't have a great run during the last few years. You know that he was struggling. He was defeated to Muhammad Laval and Charles Onen, but he defeated Wanderlei Silva in their fourth bout. And he is the former Bellator Season 10 Light Heavyweight Tournament winner, the man who fought for UFC Light Heavyweight Championship, who even won it, a real legend of this sport. Now, looking back at Fedor's achievements, you know that he is a master of armbar, a sambo guy, a guy with great punches, the man who was undefeated for a very, very long period of time. Hell yeah. I must say that Fedor is looking to bounce back with a win. Victory over Frank Mir, victory over Charles Zone and TKO, but Ryan Bader knocked him out after 35 seconds only, and he is looking for a way to bounce back with a win. So I think Fedor is going to win here, but you never know. I mean, anything can happen right now. This is Bellator Rising Cross promotional event, and anything is possible.